Very important for South Africa to learn from other countries, which throw light on our challenges here, where we often think about them in a very insular way and get locked into our history, rather than understanding South Africa's challenges in a global context where there is an enormous amount for us to learn. The most important things we can learn are that China and India have shown us that years and years of growth are possible, and that this growth can change people's lives, men and women who have been disadvantaged for decades and decades, if not centuries, dramatically for the better. And the important thing is that you don't have to do everything at once. South Africa doesn't have to become a perfect society in every sphere where we have challenges for us to do much, much better. If you look at Brazil, which has had such a remarkable impact in the last 15 years on poverty down to single digits, on unemployment down to single digits, and on inequality, where they've seen real improvement. This society is not perfect. It has all sorts of problems, and we could go on and on about the challenges they face, but they got a few things right, and they've stuck with it year after year. And the same in India. Many things are wrong in India. They need a second round of reforms now, but they did some dramatic liberalizing reforms in the early 1990s that have paid off enormous dividends. Growth rates of 7-8% sustained over decades, and as I said, millions and millions of people moving out of absolute poverty. So South Africa should take hope from this, but we need to buckle down and agree on a few priorities, in particular how we change our labor market and how we start to attract the labor-intensive factories that can employ millions and millions of young people who have no future in South Africa today.